Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a topic which is your share capital. Share capital is the part and parcel of the balance sheet. As you can see, there is an extract that has been taken over here. We'll need to understand what exactly this is. As you can see, there's a common stock, a par value 1 with this number of shares, and this one is the authorized one, and this number of shares are the issued. So let's understand this. What exactly is the share capital part? See, the share capital is the amount of the money, you can call that as a money, and the property that a company receives through their equity financing. You can say that you receive that money with the help of equity financing. It is the important aspect of the business because, you know, it reflects how much a company has earned through the equity shares at the time of the IPO. So let's take a simple share capital example to illustrate this. Let's say there's a company called KG Inc. and it had an IPO of, let's say, 6 years. How much? 6 years ago. And by selling the equity shares to the general public, KG Inc., let's say, has sourced closely to $1 million. It has sourced closely to $1 million in the capital. Now, since the KG Inc. has become a big name and the market value of the has become closely to, say, $5 million because of the increase in the market value. However, the KG Inc. has raised only $1 million through the equity financing 6 years ago. The balance sheet will reflect same only and not the $5 million. It will reflect $1 million, not the market value of the $5 million. Now, if the KG Inc. would issue new shares of, let's say, $0.5 million, then the balance sheet of the KG Inc. would be reflecting how much? It's going to be 1.1 plus 0.5. That's 1.5 million shares. Now, this share capital example teaches us, you know, two important aspects. The first and the foremost aspects is that it has nothing to do with the market value of the company. No matter what the market value is at today, balance sheet of the company will also record what has what it earned at the time of the IPO. And secondly, it takes into account the issued price. Now, if the firm, let's say 10,000 shares of let's say $10 each, in its capital would be 1,000, that is 10,000 shares into 10, right? Now, if after 5 years the market price of the share, if that becomes 200, the capital will be only be in total 1 lakh. That's going to be the total capital until the firm issues the new shares. So let's understand this with the help of the formula. See, the share capital formula is something like this. The share capital formula is equal to the issue price per share into number of shares outstanding. Number of outstanding shares. Now, this share capital formula can look a simple formula, but we need to break down the issue price into two main components. One is called the par value and the another is called the additional paid in capital. That's the second. The next formula takes care of that. The second formula for this, you know, the two main component of the issue price, the par value and the additional capital. I'm going to discuss the second formula with the par value. The par value is the amount that the firm can call its legal capital. You can say, in other words, par value is the minimum and amount the price of the shareholders must pay to acquire the shares of the company. And secondly, the additional paid in capital is the amount that is in the excess of the par value. So if we deduct the par value from the issue price, we'll get the additional paid in capital. So the formula will go something like this. Share capital will be equal to your number of shares into the par value of the stock. Par value of the stock, we need to add the paid in capital over here in excess of the par, that will be in the excess of the par value. So the share capital formula is this one is the second formula. Let's understand the third formula in this. Let's say if a company issues a shares at no par value, completely no par value, then there would be no additional paid in capital. Okay, so we would create a contributed capital over here. Now, the contributed capital in this scenario accounts and, you know, it transfers the whole amount to that. Let's say there is a company B which has issued in total 10,000 shares at a par value at 10 per share with the number of par value. So here we would transfer the whole amount, that is 10,000 shares into 10, that is 1 million in total. I mean, this should be 1 lakh, okay. So now 1 million will be took to the contributed surplus account, and there will be no additional paid in capital. So the concept of the additional paid in capital will come only when there would be par value per share. So the share capital over here will be equal to your common stock proceeds. Let's understand this with the help of an example to get into a more clear way. Let's take a share capital calculation example to illustrate this. Let's say there's a company called KG Inc. and it has issued, let's say, 1 lakh shares at an issue price of 10 per share. The par value over here is, let's say, standing at $1 per share. What we need to calculate is the share capital and its par value amount and the additional paid in capital portion. So the total capital would be, by using the share capital formula, will go something like this. The share capital formula is equal to your issue price per share into number of outstanding shares. So that's gonna be 1 lakh into 10, right? That's 1 million. So now it has two portions, the par value amount and the additional amount, that is the paid in capital. And here the par value is, since $1, then the total par value amount would be gonna be the total number of shares into 1. There'll be no change in that. Now if the par value of the share is $1 per share, and if the issue price per share is 10 per share, then the additional paid in capital per share would be is equal to 10 minus 1, that's $9 per share. That means the total additional capital, that means the total additional paid in capital would be $9 into 1 lakh shares, that's 9 lakh. And if we add the total par value amount and the additional paid in capital, will get the same amount that we got by multiplying the issue price per share and the number of the shares outstanding. Right? Now, let's understand the share capital and the balance sheet. See, when a company needs more money, then it can raise the required capital in the multiple way. It can issue bonds, or it can take a debt from the bank or even the financial institution. Right, so it can also take a debt from a bank or the financial institution, and it can also take the help of the equity shares and raise the capital. But how does it helps the company's balance sheet, the assets and the liabilities we are talking about? And that's the question I'm asking. See, when a company issues equity or the preference shares, it receives what? Cash. Now, cash is the asset. It's an asset, right? And as the company is liable to the shareholders, the share capital would be a liability. So by debiting the cash, or recording, you can say, the cash or as an asset, and crediting the share capital or recording as a liability, which will be created, a company can balance both the asset and the liability.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.